Hi, I'm Doug Seven, Senior Director at Microsoft Health Next. I want to welcome you back to the final video in this series on the Azure API for Fire. For this video, I'd like to introduce Rashmi Raj, who's a director at Microsoft Health Next.
Hello, my name is Rashmi Raj. I lead engineering team for health data ingestion. Today, I'm going to demo total knee replacement using Azure IoT Connector for Fire. But before we do the demo, let's do a quick overview of Azure IoT Connector and Fire. FHIR stands for Fast Healthcare Interoperability Resources. This is an emerging standard for health data exchange. We have released FHIR Server as open source on GitHub, and we have also released Azure API for FHIR as a managed service on Azure. To enrich the ecosystem of FHIR, we have released services and tools to ingest data from different sources, persist it in FHIR, and make it available for downstream consumptions. In this demo, we are going to focus on IoMT, Internet of Medical Things. These are devices, wearables, and sensors collecting data, which can be used to improve health outcomes. We have released IoMT FHIR Connector as open source on GitHub, and we have also released Azure IoT Connector for FHIR as a managed feature of Azure API for FHIR. This provides end-to-end data pipeline from these devices for PHI data, and bring it to Azure API for FHIR. It seamlessly integrates with IoT Hub and IoT Central, and it's scalable and easy to use. In this demo, we will use two devices, Activity Watch and Knee Brace, and the data will flow to FHIR using the IoT connector. The data from EMR will also flow to FHIR using FHIR APIs, and we will use Power BI connector for FHIR to visualize the data in Power BI, and this dashboard will be embedded in Dynamics 365. With this, let's go into the demo. So we are looking at Sarah, who is 52 years old woman, and she's going through total knee replacement surgery. Before the surgery, she has also opted in pre-op program where she has been given an activity watch. Activity watch is recording her activity level. Think of it something like Garmin Fitbit, which is recording her step count activity level along with her heart rate and sleep data. In this dashboard, a care team can see Sarah's pre-op activity data, but along with it, a care team can also see her medication data, her reported pain level data, which is coming from EMR. And this is where Power of FHIR comes in, which allows you to bring data from different sources and interoperate them, aggregate them for longitudinal view of the patient. Care team can also go and do deep dive in the data. Care team can look at heart rate, sleep quality as well. And now Sarah has gone through the surgery and care team would like to make personalized rehab decision for her. The data that came to the system and along with historical and other patient data allows to enable data analytics and proactive precision rehab scenario here. So the system gives the visualization based on real data for the preferred path for Sarah for the rehab. She's been recommended to use patient at home rehab with physiotherapy visit. At this time, care team can also use clinical judgment or previous experience to slice and dice data. For example, they can look at other patients like Sarah who have gone through the surgery. So other patients who are also female, similar age range, similar disease status, smoking status, and similar pre-op level, and what was the recommended path for them. At this time, based on the data and analytics capabilities, Sarah has been recommended for at-home rehab with physiotherapy. And when she goes home, she has also been given a knee brace, which can record her exercise level, her knee extension and flexion as well. The same pipeline which was built for Activity Watch can be used for knee brace data now. And this is where the scalability of the platform comes in, where you build this end-to-end pipeline once and scale it for new devices or scale it for more devices. Now the data starts flowing in real time in this system, and the system also provides notification capability if Sarah needs attention. So this is an example where care team can get notification if Sarah is not following her regimen or needs attention. And care team can go and look at her data. Care team can see her extension and flexion data as compared to the goal, can see her exercise level data, and indeed Sarah is not following her trajectory path. This may be an example where care team schedules home physiotherapy visit. And since this dashboard is also available on mobile device, the home team can also take this data along when they go and visit Sarah. And after the physiotherapy visit, Sarah starts following the recommended recovery path. This is an example where Azure API for Fire and IoT connector can allow ingesting data from different sources, from EMRs, as well as from devices, real-time data, and enable analytics scenarios. This is just an example. Same technology and architecture platform can be expanded to support scenarios like chronic disease management and telehealth as well. In summary, we saw how Open FHIR standard and tools and services that we are building is removing barriers of data interoperability and allowing you to bring data from different sources to enable scenarios like remote patient monitoring, precision rehabilitation, and distributed clinical trials. Thank you for watching the demo.
Thank you, Rashmi. And thank you for taking the time to watch this video series on the Azure API for FHIR. In this video series, we showed you everything from why FHIR is becoming important in health technology today to how to use the Azure API for FHIR when building your solutions. You can follow the links on the screen to learn more about how to use the Azure API for FHIR and everything you saw in this video series. Thank you very much.